பால்சு டீத்தில் அலுவா சாப்பிட்டு டீத்து அலுவாக்குள்ள போயிடுது. தே ஆர் கால்டு பக்ஷ்யம். த செகண்ட் ஒன் ஈஸ் போஜ்யம். டூஸ் டைப்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஃபுட் விச் யூ டைரக்ட்லி ஸ்வாலோ. லிக்விட் டைப் ஆஃப் ஃபுட் லைக் மில்க் ஆர் சூப் ஆர் காஃபி ஆர் டீ which are directly swallowed. You don't require to masticate. So to be masticated, to be swallowed, second type, called bhojyam. The third one is called lehyam. Lehyam means that which has to be licked and consumed. You cannot directly pour into the mouth like honey. Honey, you should not directly pour. It is a viscous liquid. Nera ulla chapata, sometimes one will be even dead. We should never do that. It has to be licked. Or Ayurvedic lehyam sirukave irukke. It is derived from the root lich to lick. English name, adhe maari dhaan vandirukku, lich to lick. And all forms of pickles will come under lehyam. Which is nanna nakanitram illaya. They are all called lehyam. This is the third one. And the fourth one is choshyam, which has to be sucked inside. Like the sugar cane, etc. You bite and you suck inside. Urinjaradu shulwala tamila. And the urinjaradu peru sucking. Our modern day example is what? The way you consume the soft drinks with a straw. How do you do that? So traditionally they pour like this. The head is up. When the head is up, it becomes bhojyam. But when the head is down, you have got a straw. That is called choshyam. And in Andhra Pradesh, there is a mango called rasalu. So you press it well and remove the cork. Cork is the tip you remove and it goes inside. So they all come under choshyam. So bhakshya, bhojya, lehya, choshya. These are the only four types of eating. Try to imagine the fifth type. Kadayada. Don't say intravenous. Adalan chadukupadada. So intravenous fielding. Nasal feeding, adella irregular, exceptional. A normal, healthy human being will use only these four. And Krishna says, all these types of food, I cook or I digest in the form of digestive fire. And naturally, the question will come, the external fire is kindled by fanning. Elio. So when they want to do a homa or even in cooking, the fire is kindled by fanning. Now alone gas stove has come, no fanning at all required. In the olden days, whether it is the fire for cooking or whether it is the fire for oblation offering, they will fan. Or they will use a kozhal also. Adhukku pera homa kozhal. Na homa kozhal, homa thala pandu. It is not homam, homa kozhai. So if the external fire is kindled by fanning, the question comes, how is the internal digestive fire kindled? Krishna says, that is also done by fanning alone. You require another type of fanning What is that? Prana apana, breathing in and breathing out is the fanning of the digestive fire. And therefore, whenever you do extra activity, which we never do, what happens? Breathing becomes faster. And when breathing becomes faster, what happens? Internal fire is kindled with speed, intensely. And therefore, Vaishwanara Agni becomes big. And when Vaishwanara Agni is kindled, what happens? You feel hunger, therefore you eat more. When the breathing slows down, hunger slows down. When breathing increases, hunger increases. From that it is clear, breathing is the fanning of the digestive fire. Therefore, Krishna says, prana apana. Prana means breathing out or exhalation. Apana here means breathing in or inhalation. So, samayuktaha means supported by, activated by the breathing. I, in the form of Vaishwanara Agni, digest the food. And that is the Agni Shakti. And therefore, he Arjuna, appreciate me in the creation in the form of Surya Shakti, Chandra Shakti and Agni Shakti. And therefore, I am everything. And now Krishna concludes that topic. Sarvasya chaham hridi sannivishtah. Matta smritir jnanam apohanancha. Vedaischa sarvairahameva vedyah. Vedanta krid veda videva chaham. So here Krishna concludes this topic pointing out, I am everything. I am in everything. Sarvasya hridi aham sannivishtaha. He Arjuna, I the Paramatma reside in the heart of everyone. So every body is like a temple. The heart represents the mind. The mind represents the sanctum or garbhagriham, dehaha devalayaha, and mind is the garbhagriham, and in that mind, I, the Paramatma, am present as the Jivatma, witnessing every thought occurring in the mind. Therefore, hridi, Sakshi Chaitanya Rupena, Kshetrajna Rupena, in the form of the very consciousness, I am in every living being. And Mattaha, because of me, the consciousness alone, all the functions of the body are going on. Mattaha smritihi jnanam apohanancha. All the mental faculties are alive because of me. What are some of the faculties? Jnanam. Jnanam means what? The capacity to learn. Learning faculty is alive because of me. Then smritihi, learning should be followed by what? Remembering. இல்லையோ இல்லைன்னா அடுத்த கிளாஸில் திருப்பியும் 15th சாப்டர் எடுக்கலாம். ஸோ ஸ்மிருதிஹி ரிமம்பரிங் ஃபேக்கல்டி ஈஸ் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் மீ. அண்ட் சம் பீப்புள் மே சே, சுவாமிஜி ஐ டோன்ட் ஹாவ் ரிமம்பரிங் ஃபேக்கல்டி, ஐ ஹாவ் காட் ஃபர்கெட்டிங் ஃபேக்கல்டி. அண்ட் ரிமம்பர், ஃபர்கெட்ஃபுல்னஸ் வி திங்க் இஸ் எ கர்ஸ், but remember forgetfulness is also important because we go through lot of painful experiences in life. In due course we have to forget them. Imagine if you remember all the painful experiences, you will feel terrible. And that is why we say time is a healer, because in time we forget those things. Therefore, remembering is also an important faculty. Forgetfulness is also important faculty. But the problem is, what should be remembered? What should be forgotten? Angada chinna thagararana. All our classes are very successfully forgotten. And somebody did something, he said something in 1953, annakke nee andha vaartha sonna, what a memory power. So Krishna says, what is to be remembered, remember. What is to be forgotten, you forget. Both faculties are a blessing, and both of them are my glory alone. And one commentator gives a special meaning for these three words. It's a very beautiful thing, not given by Shankaracharya, but some other acharya. He says, jnanam refers to the waking state, because in waking state, we are gathering fresh experiences. Smritihi represents dream state, because in dream we don't gather anything new, only what is already registered, that is projected again. Therefore, smriti indicates svapnavastha, and apohanam means forgetfulness. And forgetfulness represents sushupti avastha, because in sleep we forget everything. Therefore, jnanam jagrati, smritihi svapna, apohanam sushupti, all the three avasthas are because of me alone. So I am in everyone responsible for their experiences in all the three states. And not only that, sarvaihi vedaihi ahameva vedyaha. I am the subject matter of all the scriptures, because scriptures are dealing with the Lord alone. The Veda Purva Bhaga is dealing with Saguna Ishvara. Veda Anta Bhaga is dealing with Nirguna Ishvara. In short, the entire Veda is dealing with what? Ishvara alone. Therefore, he says, through all the four Vedas, I am the one to be known. And Vedanta Krit Aham, and I am the one who is the initiator of the Vedantic tradition. Vedantic tradition includes the Vedic also. The entire Vedic tradition I have initiated. So therefore, what is known through the Veda, I am. And the Vedas themselves are nothing but myself or my creation. Then what about the students of the Vedic teaching? He says the students are also myself. So Veda with means the student, the knower of Veda. So the knower I am, the known I am, the means of knowledge I am, pramata, pramanam, prameyam, the entire triputi I am. And therefore, I am everything. So with this, Krishna concludes the second topic also. And what is the second topic? I am in the form of the insentient world also. Previously he said, I am in the form of the sentient living beings also. Therefore, chetana achetana prapanchaha aham asmi. This is called sarvatmakatvam. More in the next class. Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Sadashiva samarambham shankaracharya madhyamam asmadacharya paryantam vande guru paramparam. Om. With the 15th verse which we completed in the last class, Lord Krishna completes the important topic of Brahmanaha Sarvatmakatvam. Brahmanaha Sarvatmakatvam means Brahman alone is in the form of everything. Sarvam Brahmamayam Jagat. Very careful. Sarvam Brahmamayam Jagat Shalabhradhi. Brahma means confusion. It is Brahma. And this is the essential teaching of all the Upanishads. In the Mundakopanishad we saw Brahmaivaitadamrutam purastat Brahma paschat Brahma dakshinatascha uttarena adhascha urdhvancha prasritam Brahmai vedam vishwamidam varishtam. What is in front is Brahman, what is behind is Brahman, on the right, on the left, below, above. Everything is Brahman with different names and forms which cause only a superficial difference. So the world is superficially different, but in essence the whole world is Brahman. There is nothing other than Brahman. And Krishna has mentioned this in the 4th chapter also. Brahmarpanam Brahmahavir Brahmagnav Brahmanahutam Brahmaivatena Gantavyam Brahmakarma Samadhina. That verse also conveys the same idea. Brahman alone is everything. And this topic Krishna started from the 7th verse. And he concluded this in the 15th verse. And we should remember that the ultimate discovery is that sarvatmakam brahma is nothing but myself. It is not enough that we say Brahman is everything, there the sadhana is incomplete. I should finally say that Brahman I am. And then the statement will be reworded. Instead of saying Brahman is everything, we say I am everything. Aham annam, aham annadaha, aham sloka krithu, ahameva idagum sarvam. This is called sarva atma bhavaha. And that we completed in the last class. Now in the following three verses, 16, 17 and 18, Krishna gives the definition of the word purushottamaha. And based on this word alone, the very chapter is called purushottama yogaha. So what is purushottama? Who is purushottama? Krishna tells in these three verses. We will read verse 16. Dvavi mau purushau loke. Ksharascha kshara eva cha. Ksharasarvani bhutani. Kutastho kshara uchyate. First, I will give you the gist, the essence of these three verses, so that you will get a total picture. Then, understanding these verses will be easier. To reveal Purushottama, Lord Krishna divides the whole universe into three portions or three components. Amshatrayam he is going to talk about. What are the three portions of the universe? The first portion is the visible universe, which is accessible, perceptible to our sense organ. This sensorily visible, tangible universe is one component, and this we can call the manifest matter. Because the universe, this visible universe, is made up of matter we know. Scientifically, it has been shown that the world is made up of matter. And even scripturally, we know that the world is made up of pancha bhutani, akashavayu agni apav prithivi, and all of them are matter, inert matter principle. Therefore, the first component is what? Manifest matter. And Krishna gives a technical name for this component, and that is kshara purushaha. This manifest matter, shortened MM. Okay, manifest matter. Krishna calls Kshara Purushaha. And this we have to very carefully note, because normally matter is indicated only by the word Prakriti. Normally, matter is referred to as Prakriti Tattvam, but this is an exceptional context in which the manifest matter is called Kshara Purushaha. Then Krishna talks about the second component. What is that? When matter is destroyed, what happens to matter? We know scientifically, logically, and shastrically that matter cannot be totally destroyed. By the law of conservation of matter, and therefore when matter is destroyed, it will get converted into unmanifest form. You may call it energy form, but it goes to the invisible, intangible, unmanifest form. And therefore, at the time of the total destruction of this universe, at the time of Pralaya, the matter will continue, but not in the form of manifest matter, but it will survive in the form of unmanifest matter. And therefore, the second component of the universe is matter in unmanifest form. So, unmanifest matter, which is also inert in nature, is the second component. UM, adukku MM sonna, idu UM. UM nanadam, unmanifest matter. And Krishna gives a technical name for this as Akshara Purushaha. Akshara Purushaha. This is also an exceptionally rare usage, because normally the word Akshara Purushaha is used for Nirgunam Brahma or consciousness. That is the general meaning. But in this exceptional context, the unmanifest matter, you may call it energy, is named Akshara Purushaha. In other contexts, that alone is called Maya. Because in Vedanta, Maya is the unmanifest universe, unmanifest matter. And that Maya Tattvam, unmanifest matter principle, in this context is called Akshara Purushaha. So we have manifest matter, unmanifest matter, Kshara Purusha, Akshara Purushaha. Then the third component of the entire cosmos is the